Welcome to this video playing Ross. Yeah, I've not played this guy before here, the 5-minute pool on ICC, and let's see what I can get going. Yeah, my rating really has taken a slump in the recent games. Didn't play well in the last session. And I also lost my warm-up game pretty miserably. Yeah, after initially outplaying the guy, I really played badly. So let's see what happens here. Taking on c4 and going for
draw offered.
What's this? No. why draw? No idea why. It's just a normal kind of position here. So let's see how to play here. Probably just castles. Looks normal. So he goes a6. Yeah, e4 e5 is an interesting way to play. I'm going for that, trying to exploit my better development here, and possibly after e5 knight moves, bishop g5 is good. Over to d3. Now ready for e5. Let's see if he goes bishop b7 or, yeah, probably. I can even consider bishop g5 after bishop b7, intending to play e5. It's not a bad idea. But e5 also is good. Yeah, I don't know. What is he doing? Bishop b7 looks very normal. Have some doubts about other moves. I don't know, but what else is there? Okay, so this one. Yeah, bishop g5 to provoke f6. I don't know if this is a good idea, but probably it is. Like f6, bishop e3, I'm immediately threatening to trap the knight with g4. So g4 now is a pretty big idea. Okay, I can play both actually. Queen takes and pawn takes. Pawn takes is interesting. Because it opens up the f-file. But okay, let's not be too sophisticated here. White will have an advantage no matter what, so playing quickly certainly makes some sense. He has to play some awkward looking move now. Either e5, which allows knight d5, that looks really bad, or g6 to give his knight some retreat square. Maybe g5, but also this doesn't look like the right way to play. Yeah, okay, so I have knight d5 now. I also have a4, which is also interesting. Yeah, I think this is a good idea, probably. Fighting for the c4 square. Yeah, assuming he goes b4, but then I have knight d5, double attacking a pawn and the queen already. Quite a tricky thing. Okay, so he's giving up a pawn. Going to grab him. He's giving away the b5 pawn. Yeah, maybe that was necessary. Yeah, knight d5 was a big problem. I could have played knight d4 before I went a4. Maybe that was even the best try. First knight d5, let his queen move and then go a4. Maybe that was even better. Okay, this is a very nice position now, but still. Yeah, this is just a pawn for basically nothing. Not exactly a move I expected, but difficult to give him any advice here. So what am I doing? I can take a6, But then he will take d3. Well, he cannot take b5. Probably the check is not bad, but then he has got bishop e6. Yeah, maybe continue developing here. If he moves the bishop out, I can probably just take a6 for a second pawn. The thing is, I'm not quite sure what his next move is. He really doesn't have a very clear-cut way to continue. Yeah, okay, this is a mate threat, so I should go g3 probably, or bishop f1. I can also go bishop f1. That's not a bad move. Yeah, let's do that. It's not bad. Cover g2 like that and get out of the knight here, so the knight cannot trade itself. I have knight d5 to try to get rid of this piece anyway, and knight h3 is really just a check, not more. Knight d5 is a key move. I think I should play this now. Just get rid of the f4 knight or this bishop. In both cases, it's good. I get a passed d pawn or get rid of his strong knight on f4. So that cannot be a really bad move. Yeah, this is also quite nice.
Check.
But well, it was already.
Black resigns.
Already pretty bad. Yeah, it was one of his first games, so this is a provisional rating. Yeah, we see that in other time controls he's much lower. Not like bad, but just lower. And 2-4 something was a bit high. He had won the first four games. So this happens, yeah, those provisional games. Yeah, I wondered a bit. I thought he didn't really play like 2-4 something. But okay, so it started by taking this here early, which gives me basically, yeah, almost a free move. Quite often white will have to move the bishop and then black takes, so he gives me a tempo in a way. c5. Yeah, this is a very simple way to play. Just take on c5. Of course, I can just castle and am okay, but I didn't know. I think dc5 was okay. I expected actually the trade like this.
Check.
And here white is a little bit better. I simply have the slightly more active pieces. I'm a bit better developed, but it's not something that black should be very much afraid of. He can probably hold this position somehow. Okay, but he went here, and now I kept the queens on for a future rook d1 with tempo. But okay, he went to e7 voluntarily, and now here now it gets tricky really. I expected bishop b7, but it's possible that e5 is already really really problematic. Yeah, the computer is actually showing that
check.
Bishop h7 is a move. I wasn't sure about that, but
check.
it seems that now this is actually just working. Yeah? He cannot go to g6. Queen d3 is really
check.
A total
check.
Total disaster. So he has to go back, and here he's getting killed. Yeah, so this was a real problem already. Knight h5. Yeah, okay, I provoked f6 here, and then went back. Now I'm threatening g4, yeah, trapping the knight, so he takes. Yeah, and f takes was interesting. That's not a bad move. I mean, the idea is like that's, let's say, like g6 and then e5. But I wasn't sure how good this is. I mean, his bishop is getting some scope there as well. Queen takes is a simpler move and probably the better move. Yeah, I was expecting g6 now, which is a bit ugly looking, but providing some retreat square. e5, I thought, looks really weird, allowing knight d5. Maybe knight d5 immediately was better. That's possible. Yeah, like the queen now moves, and then I'm going a4, which even make sure that knight f4 is not coming. It's probably a little bit better, but it's a matter of choosing between more than one good line. It's a matter of two clear advantages. Yeah, I could have played a bit better here. Even knight h4 is given by the engine, but this is still good. I really don't see any problem with that, keeping a huge advantage here. And he he blundered the queen, but it's still very bad. He can take and continue from here, but how is he continuing now? He cannot really develop the knight easily, taking there. And if he takes on b5, I can play, let's say, rook c1 for rook c7, and I can take b5 whenever I want. So it's essentially still a pawn whenever I want on b5, and the d pawn. So there was something better, but it was okay. Okay, well, thanks for watching.